बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। हाय डियर एस्पायरेंट्स ऑफ कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ सुपीरियर सर्विसेज UPSC, CSS, BPSC, PCS, स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ ग्रेजुएशन एंड मास्टर्स इन वेरियस डिसिप्लिन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे आई विल गिव लेक्चर ऑन द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक विदाउट बेसिक नॉलेज ऑफ पावरफुल कंट्रीज इट इज़ एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट फॉर स्टूडेंट टू कम्प्रिहेंड द हिस्टोरिकल पोलिटिकल इकोनॉमिक कंडीशंस ऑफ इंटरेक्टिंग स्टेट्स एंड प्रिवेंट आर प्रेजेंट नेशनल इंटरेस्ट इन एमिकेबल वे। विदाउट बेसिक डेटा ऑफ एनी टॉपिक इट इज़ डिफिकल्ट टू राइट अ डिटेल्ड एसे आर डिस्क्राइब इंटरकनेक्टेड फैक्ट्स एसेंशियल फॉर एनी टॉपिक। The topic is the basic information about the countries of North and East Asia, which comprises Russia, China, Japan, and Korean Peninsula, that is South Korea and North Korea. The information about Russia has been given in my previous lecture, available on my channel. Without knowledge of history, any country's history, political system, what is their political system, how they are running their state, and past conduct, what they did, how they did, with whom they did, past conduct of relations with other countries of the world, one cannot understand their importance in world politics, or it will be difficult to interact with these powers. Today, foreign policy and economic relations in complicated and interdependent politics is very difficult. The student must know the basic data, basic history of the interacting states, mainly the major powers. Students must bear in mind, in world politics, there is no permanent friends or foes, but what is permanent? Permanent is the national interest of a country. Let us start with China. China is a country lying in the North Asia, below the Russia, and it is bordering with 16 countries. Its capital is Beijing, its currency is Yuan. The Qing dynasty, which lasted from 1644 until 1912, was the last imperial dynasty of China. The Xinhai Revolution of 1911 and 12 brought an end to the Qing dynasty and established the Republic of China on 1st January 1912, and the Sun Yat-sen of the Kuomintang, our nationalist party, was proclaimed as provisional president. China has the credit of inventing four great inventions: paper making, the compass, agriculture and medical inventions, gunpowder, and movable types in other were invented in the Tang dynasty, which lasted from 618 to 907. The Tang culture spread that young culture spread widely in Asia and in entire Asia with neighboring countries as the new Silk Route of old times brought traders to as far as Mesopotamia, which is now which is called Iraq, and the Horn of Africa, or the tip of the Africa. China was ravaged by feudal warlordism and Japan during the World War II. The subsequent Chinese Civil War resulted in the division of territory in 1949 when the Communist Party of China, led by Mao Zedong, established the People's Republic of China on mainland of China. While the Kuomintang, our Nationalist Party, retreated to the island of Taiwan. The political dispute status of Taiwan remains disputed till today. Now let us come to the Chinese political system. China is a unitary one-party socialist republic and is one of the few existing socialist states. The People's Republic of China is a permanent member of United Nations Security Council with veto power. It replaced the Republic of China in 1971 as well as an active global partner of ASEAN. China has gained the status of superpower mainly because of its massive productive population, large and rapidly growing economy. Rapidly growing economy, technological advancement, and powerful military with most advanced weaponry. The Second Sino-Japanese War was fought in 1937 to 1945. During the war, China, along with United Kingdom, the United States and the Soviet Union, were referred to as trusteeship of the powerful and were recognized as the Allied Big Four in the Declaration of the United Nations. Along with the other three great powers, China was one of the four major allies of World War II and was later considered one of the primary victors in the war. The continued distrust between Kuomintang and Communist led to the resumption of civil war. On 21st September 1949, Communist Party Chairman Mao proclaimed the establishment of People's Republic of China. This was followed by a mass celebration in Tiananmen Square on 1st October 1949, the date becoming the new country's first national day. China was also a former member and leader of non-aligned movement and still considered itself an advocate for developing countries. National People's Congress, its political system, its parliament's name is National People's Congress, consist of more than 3,000 members. That's why it is called largest parliament of the world. China consists of 90% Han race. There are 292 languages spoken in China. Macau, a territory occupied by the Portugal, recognized as Chinese, handed over to China on December 1999. Macau, the last remaining dependent state in Asia, the final vestige of European colonialism in the region, in Asia, reverted to Chinese sovereignty after 442 years of Portuguese rule. But Portugal is a very small country of Europe. How it occupied a far land of China is a pity. Chinese constitution was adopted in 1949. Present constitution was adopted in 1982. It has 138 articles. China has 23 provinces. President of China is elected for 5-year term. Executive powers rest with the State Council. Members of National People's Congress are chosen for 5 years. Its parliament is working through standing committees of 150 members in place of NPC or National People's Congress, which exercise all power. Highest court of the China is Supreme People's Court. Gang of Four trial was arrested or tried from 80 to 81. Now, presently, along with Brazil, Russia, India, and South Africa, China is a member of BRICS group of emerging major economies and established the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, AIIB, which is a multilateral development bank that aims to support the building of infrastructure in the Asia-Pacific region. The bank started operation after the agreement entered into force on 25th December 2015. Its headquarters is in China and its members are 97. AIIB bank is considered opposing bloc or bank or mayor to counter the policies of IMF and World Bank in the world. People's Republic of China is seated in the United Security Council on 23rd November 1971. Prior to it, Taiwan was the member of the Security Council. China is a founder of SCO. Now come to its relation with the US. Pakistan played a major role in normalizing relations of USA and China. And China also recognized it. Now another country is in North Asia is Japan. North Asia or East Asia is Japan, and Tokyo is its capital, yen is its currency. Now come to its history. In 1853, US Free Forces opened to influence the Japan to open up foreign influence after 200 years of self-imposed isolation, because Japan did not maintain relation with other states, and US forced Japan to open it, like Switzerland. In 1868, Empire of Japan proclaimed, and country enters period of rapid industrialization and imperial expansion. Industrialization again, they have to sell their products into the markets of the world. That's why they followed the policy of imperial expansionism like Europeans. In 1910, Japan annexes Korea. Again, in 1914, Japan joins First World War on the side of Britain, gaining some Pacific islands from Germany. In 1925, universal male suffrage was introduced in Japan. In 1930s, Japan seizes Chinese province of Manchu, Shanghai, Beijing. In 1939 to 1945, Second World War sees Japan occupying several Asian countries. It is defeated when US dropped atomic bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki on 6th and 9th August 1945. In 1945 again, US occupy devastated country, and post-war recovery and political reforms were started by General MacArthur, who founded the foundation of modern Japan, industrialized Japan, peaceful Japan. And at that time, Emperor Hirohito surrendered and relinquishes the divine status. Our Japanese military and naval forces disbanded by the US. In 1947, new constitution came into force, established parliamentary system. Japan renounces war and pledged not to maintain land, sea or air force for their purpose. Emperor granted ceremonial power. Now the present emperor has a ceremonial power. He has no any executive power. The executive power rests with parliament. In 1951, Japan signed treaty with the US and other countries. The old name of Japan is Nippon, and it's also called origin of the sun or rising sun, land of the rising sun. Meiji Emperor was in 1868 to 1912. Head of state is emperor. He has ceremonial powers. There are 47 provinces or it's called prefectures. Its parliament is called Diet, which is a bicameral legislature. Its houses are called House of Representatives, which is lower house, consists of 480 members, elected for 4-year term. And its upper house is called House of Councillors, and it has 252 members. Supreme Court of Japan has 15 judges. Japanese people are peaceful and loving. They have supported economically and morally the third world countries and voiced on every forum for their rights and issues, any issues on the forum of United Nations or on other forums. They have voiced in favor of the Japanese people. Thank you very much.